once athletes have a good control of their slide and a good grasp of how to row correctly, then an important step in getting the maximum boat speed is to be able to let the boat do the work, let the boat run. And so what you need to do is, as they come off the back, as I've described before, the handle wants to come in at the same speed that it goes out, then the shoulders move at the same speed, the seat starts to move at the same speed, and then, depending on the athlete, there's a different ways of describing the next part of the process. If they're going to get it right, then what they want to do is they want to have no weight on the foot stretcher as they're coming into the front, so they let the boat go. They want to eke out as much run out of the boat as they can in that last part of the recovery. And so a few words that I would use to describe it. One is, as they come off the back, then get them to a half slide on the way forward to consciously slow down. Some would even say stop. Now, they don't stop, obviously, but what happens is that the boat tends to run under them and they come into the front really gently. A couple of other ways to describe it that works with athletes is, one would be to say that, imagine there's a cushion of air under the sole of your shoe that you don't want to push on. You just hold that gap under your shoe as you come into the front. They're the types of language that we've been using with athletes, and they seem to understand what it means. The general purpose, of course, is to have a powerful drive phase, let the boat run, and don't cheese it off on the way down. So gently into the front, making sure you have no weight on the foot stretcher, and in fact have the blade going into the water before you actually apply any weight to the foot stretcher. If you do that, then you'll find that the stern of the boat doesn't dip at all, or very little, and the boat just gets picked up and runs again. So the stern of the boat will have this sort of a movement, rather than this sort of a movement. And it's really important to be able to grasp that, because you'll find if they get that, then the rowing simply becomes a lot easier. Additionally, you'll find that it's easy for them to do that at slowest rating. So if they can do it at 20, then the challenge is being able to do it at a higher rating. And if they get up and they can do it at, say, 32, 33, then you'll find you've got a very fast boat indeed for the power of the athlete. The easiest way to build it up is to gradually work it up, work the rating up, and getting the same level of competency at each level as they go up. Often you'll find they can do it well at rating 20, 22, but as soon as it comes to doing it at 28 or 30, you'll find that the boat's getting stopped each time they come to the catch. In essence, they're pushing the boat backwards with their feet before they've got their blade in the water. And we'll demonstrate the way that you can show this to athletes in a very practical sense in the boat now.